obvious stars, statements, and legends. Tens across the board. Hold them close for me. DJ, start the music.
Let's go.
people here and I'm there? Oh my god, I see you! Holy shit, it's like Gladiator. I'm gonna kill Daya.
Oh, take me out of my misery.
Oh my gosh, you guys, we are so excited to be here. We have been wanting to come to Australia and we're fun with over here.
In case you don't know, this is our last show of this tour tonight. We're saving it all for you, special little motherfuckers. So we need the utmost fucking energy to end this tour and have the best night of our lives.
So I've been wanting to come to Australia since I was like 5 years old because I'm obsessed with koalas. Like obsessed with them. One thing I wish that was different here though is I wish that weed was legalized. It's actually really funny. The other day, we were in the airport and of course running behind because we're drag queens and we can never be on time. And I didn't have time to grab breakfast and I was like waiting in line at the gate for the flight to board and I turn around and Willow is eating. And I'm like, bitch, what are you eating? And she goes, chicken pot pie. And I'm like, baby, pot is illegal here.
She's not very smart. And we want that. But no, Di's, we had so much fucking fun in Australia. We did actually get to see the koalas. Di did fuck a couple.
I already had chlamydia.
Yeah, she already had it.
But we just want to know, did you guys enjoy RuPaul's Drag Race season 14?
Yeah,
we're in all super
ways. Yeah, all the way here in Perth. First of all, I knew like very little about Perth before I came here. And I did some research. I did some research on the way here and I found out that y'all had the first gay club in Australia. That was fact number one, and then I found out you are home to the Quokka.
Yeah!
And then this is the most shocking thing, is I found the people of the Perth have the juiciest, most eatable asses. A lot of crazy facts, and I'm really excited to be here.
We're learning so much, Okay, do we have any like crazy, speaking of season 14, any crazy super fans? Anybody that's like, but when you say super fans, like, you know everything about every moment of the show.
Anyone that wants to play a game?
Yeah. Anyone that wants to play a game and show off their knowledge of season 14?
Daya, why don't you choose one person and I'll choose one person?
I want somebody that 100% knows pretty much everything about the season.
I know she's you in the video.
Alright, well, wait. It's like, literally, we need to battle to the death to figure this out. Okay, is there a way to get down from this balcony? Okay, make your way down here, I don't know. Don't hurt yourself, don't crawl, don't climb. Yeah, I love, y'all are a rowdy bunch, I like it. I like it. Wait, okay, question. So, out of the top five, and you can answer this later, but we prefer to answer now. Who sounds the most American?
Everyone would go to say that.
Yeah, why? What is it? I sound white trash, yes. Accurate, very accurate. I'm pretty sure like every venue we've asked like people behind the scenes and stuff and they all said diabetes, so
yeah.
Terrible quality to have. Terrible. Where's my buddy? Is he down here? Yeah, okay. Oh, there's one. Perfect. Okay, come on up, don't hurt yourself. You don't want to rip any more of that shirt off.
We're American.
Oh, perfect. Okay, right there, baby. Right through that hole. Right through that hole. Who knew? Was a comedy queen.
Yay!
Come on, baby. All right.
Honey, what's your name?
Marcus.
Marcus, so where are you from?
I'm actually from Singapore, which is a 5-hour flight from Perth. I came all the way here to see you all.
And can you give me something to say in an Australian accent? This part of the game is the work when you're from Singapore.
Yeah, I try. Good day, mate.
Good day, mate.
Yes.
All right, baby, what's your name?
Noah.
Everyone say, hey, Noah.
Hey, Noah.
Noah, where are you from in this beautiful country?
Perth.
Perth, yes. A hometown hero right here on the stage, you guys. Okay, and give me something to say in Australia. Say whatever you want.
You fucking cunt!
You fucking cunt! I should be better at that. I say that all the time. Alright, dear Willow, you want to explain the rules of the game?
Yes.
So we're doing a little bit of trivia on season 14, and whoever gets the most points wins some custom Willow Pill merch. And whoever loses gets a t-shirt with Diabetes face on it. Are you ready to play? All right, let's begin. We're going to do three questions each, and then they're progressively harder. Are you ready? First question. On season 14, when Diabetes ate a dragonfly, what did Cornbread promise her?
$1,000.
That is correct. With no help from anyone at all.
Alright, honey, your first question is, finish the lyric to our number one Billboard Grammy-nominated hit, Bad Boy Baby.
Number one song on iTunes.
Ready? No help from the audience. He follows us everywhere we go. He looks like our uncle, but I wouldn't know. You do not know. The correct answer was, we can't say no.
We love ancestors.
Yeah, Americans, you know.
Australians into incest. Okay. I need to go to Tasmania.
That's my favorite fact I've learned since I've been here. I will be tweeting that.
Where is our Tasmanian tour?
Is anyone here from Tasmania?
Yeah!
Yeah! I thought you guys all looked alike. Fucking RuPaul, she doesn't know shit. Okay.
Alright, are you ready for your second question?
I'll try.
Alright, good, because I forget the question. Diabetic, remind me. Yes. This is our seventh show, I know. Right. Just like I thought. This season was a little controversial because it's so many episodes where nobody fucking went home. Tell me, how many times did that happen?
Three times.
Not including me and Orion coming back.
Okay.
Because that doesn't happen.
Sorry. Okay,
there's at least 3 to 4. 3 to 5.
I'm gonna get 4. It's 5. You're so close. I wish you were right, but it's 5.
Alright, so you have a chance to catch up, honey. Are you ready? Okay. So, during our season, we had a double Shantae between Georges and Jasmine Kennedy. Name the name of the song that they lip sync to. Stick a wild guess. Anything. Say what? It's not hot on the floor.
That's not a song.
The correct answer was something's got a hold on me.
All right.
It's okay. It's okay. You're cute.
We're all getting to the third round, so this is going to be the hardest question. Are you ready? During Snatch Game, how many laughs did Bosco get as good as Caltro? So many.
Bosco get as winner Caltro? Well, zero.
That's correct!
Actually, everyone didn't get any laughs.
They thought we were a too tough competition. Wasn't fair.
Deja will appreciate that. Alright, okay, are you ready for your final question? Alright, so RuPaul famously told Lady Camden that she needs to fix her lips and draw them bigger. What else about Lady Camden's makeup should she change? Who said that? Are you from Tasmania? Something's wrong with the eyes, I can feel it. It's not. We would have accepted anything except for that answer. Damn, honey. Well, you know what? We have one last question.
Yeah. This is a winner takes all question.
Winner takes all, so it's anyone's game.
Come in to me.
We don't like to be fair, just like RuPaul.
All right, my loves. I famously won season 14. It never gets old. And Lady Camden was my lovely runner-up. Who, in your opinion, got third? No pressure. Just say your opinion.
No pressure at all.
Cornbread! Yes!
You can't change your answer. I'll remember that one. No, the correct answer was
George's.
Well, it looks like we have a winner.
We've got some merch for both of you.
Yes.
All guys. I got this t-shirt for you, which you can purchase.
Give it up to our wonderful guests. It was so fabulous. Yes.
And we actually have a last day of tour deal going on with our merchandise.
We do. It's buy a t-shirt and a poster for $400.
$400, that's it.
No, our deal is buy a t-shirt and a poster for $40, or you can buy a t-shirt for $30 and a poster for $20 separately. I don't do math. I'm from America. I'm terrible. Okay, and if you have questions, just make sure you ask the merch lady. She's sitting right back there in the back, okay? Okay, we're going to go over quick little drag rules, just for anyone in the audience that has never been to a drag show.
Anyone here? Is this the first drag show?
Yes! Well, welcome.
Okay, well, all we need from you tonight, especially since it's our last show, is your energy, okay? We need your claps. Yes! I'm pouring you up here on the screen. Shit on this stage, I need you to scream! Yes. Alright, are y'all ready for a show?
Well, let's bring out our first guest of the evening.
She's got a fat ass
and a really bad attitude. Her name is Bosco!
Thank you.
one. Dedicate that performance to my dad. He loves it when I do that. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, that's what happens when they give me lawn furniture to perform on. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm sure every single drag queen makes this joke, but I'm going to do it right now before any of the other faggots do it. Walk into the club, Perth first. Yeah, Perth is Perth. Hello! Oh my god, thank you so much for coming out to see us! Y'all are so beautiful, this venue is fantastic, we love you so, so much. How do we feel about Diane Willa opening the show? Yeah, me neither. Yeah, I don't know why they do that. Crazy, that's a lot of attitude for somebody with only two maxi challenges between the both of them to have. Crazy. I have three. Who's counting, you know what I mean? Hi, I like your hat. You're beautiful. Oh my God. Wow. One thing I do have to say, so this is their last show, so we're using this as a little bit of like penance, a little bit of confession. Something that I really enjoyed about Australia is how much you guys enjoy the word cunt. Yeah, if I were to draw a Venn diagram with twinks from America on one side and then Australians on the other side, the intersection would be saying cunt. And I think that's nice. Okay, on the count of three, I want you all to all scream cunt at me, okay? One, two, three. I love that. Oh my god. One time right before I came out to do this number, on this tour, they're like, this is an all ages show. I'm like, that's unfortunate. So I'm so happy that this does not seem to be one of those kinds of shows. Yeah, where are my 12-year-olds at? Nowhere, fucking thank God. Perfect. So, it sounds like the most of us have been to a drag show, yeah? Lit. So, in America, we have this thing that I like to call the queer census. And that is where the drag queen takes stock of the demographics in the crowd. So, y'all are gonna join me in that. So if I call out your demographic, you make a lot of noise, okay? Yeah. Where are the straight people at? That's enough. This is not your space. Calm it down. A little too proud of the straight club. Okay. Where are my gays? Taking up a bit too much room, as per usual. Yeah, you back corner, I see you. Most importantly to me, where are the lesbians? Oh my god. That is the most important demographic, in my opinion. So, gays, you suck. No, I'm kidding. You're just very flighty. You're not a great fan base to have. You're gonna move on to the next twink that can wear Louboutins in like 2 seconds. So quick. The lesbians, though, if you win the lesbians over, you're good for life. Yeah. So lesbians, do I get to come back to Australia? These double A cups do it for you every time. Every single fucking time, what can I say? All right, where are the bisexuals? Greedy, yeah, you're one of Diane's fans. Of course you're bisexual. I do want to say that bisexual men are God's gift to me. So thank you for existing. If there's any bisexual men in the club, you can find me at hotel number, and I'm just kidding. And finally, near to my heart, where are my trans people and my non-binaries? Yeah, who checked their pronouns at the door? Who here has blue hair and also pronouns? Yeah, thank you so much. I do want to adore all of you. It's very, very hard to be trans in this world, and it's very, very hard to be trans in certain countries. America, Australia, I'm sure as well. Being trans is very, very challenging. So, I love you. Thank you for being so brave, and thank you for coming out today. Yeah. Oh my god. Yeah. If you didn't clap, you're transphobic, Blondie. Yeah, I see you. That wasn't enough noise. I see you. Yeah, she's not an ally. I'm kidding. Thank you for giving me money. I appreciate it. How do we feel about cross-dressing? How do we feel about cross-dressers mouthing words at you? What if I told you had an entire night of that before you? Can I bring out one of those cross-dressers? I don't know. She came across the entire world to see you. Would you like to see another cross-dresser? Okay, I think she might do it for that. So, this next diva is my favorite diva, who is up next. And I love her so much. I was a little bit scared for a second. I didn't think they were gonna let her in the country because when we got here, they said that we weren't allowed to bring any fruits. So, bringing to the stage next is our beautiful, incredible fruity diva, who's probably gonna give you one of these. It's Angeria!
Until
I just say, I just did a tour with Angie. We did Work the World, and now we're doing Fantastic Five. And she is one of the kindest, most genuine person I've ever worked with. So sweet. She's just so happy and so nice all the time, which equals out how terrible I am. Are y'all having fun this fall? Oh, fucking yeah. Hell yeah. Do we have any local performers in the audience tonight? Some. Well, I'm so happy you guys all turned up and turned out for us like this, but I want to remind you, we all start in the exact same place, and it is so important to rep your local girls like you're repping girls on Drag Race. So let me tell ya, you work so hard. You scrounge around for anything you can, you make outfits out of shit you've had for years, and it's a lot of work. So if you're giving all this love to us, please do that for your local girls, okay?
Yeah, love it.
Okay, can I just say something about... Sorry, you guys are probably so tired of hearing about Australia. You're like, we get it, bitch, we live here. I am so excited for Kath and Kim, the reunion. I started that show, I want to say like a year and a half ago. It was on Netflix, and I watched it all and the movies in like literally less than 3 months. Incredible. It's really nice, yeah, it's nice. It's different. Thank you. Funny story about Miss Angie. So today we had a call time to be picked up from the hotel at 4:45, okay? So we can get here, do a little run through, and have meet and greet. And none of us were all right, Jasmine Kennedy, calm down. And Angie, I come 4:45, we're all sitting in the car, but Angie's nowhere to be found. And so we gave her a call and she wasn't answering. She had fallen asleep and had no makeup on or anything. She painted her face in like literally 40 minutes here at the club, and she looks so sickening. And that, baby, that is drag. That is drag. Okay, so it wouldn't be a drag show without me making a lot of people feel uncomfortable. That's just how it goes. So thank you. I've been doing it all night. I'm going to continue. I'm going to call two people up that know how to dance. Does anyone here know how to dance or want to perform? Don't be nervous. Listen, I went on Drag Race and I didn't know how to dance. Okay, you, just because you have really supportive friends back there, come on up. Feel free to come through this curtain and then up and around the stairs. I don't want you to get hurt, baby, okay? And then do we have another? Yes? All right, baby, come on over. Let's go this way. Perfect, perfect. Everyone up here safely. Hi, dear. What's your name, honey?
Stevie.
Hey, Stevie, what's up? You are so fierce. I love this outfit. Yes. Stevie, where are you from?
Perth.
Perth. Another one. Welcome, dear. Thank you so much for joining me up here on stage. Hi, gorgeous. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Fabulous. You want to tell everyone your name, my dear?
Miss Dexie.
Hey, Miss Dexie. Now, are you from Perth as well?
Yes, I am.
We got Perth in the house tonight, okay? Okay, so we're going to do a little lip sync for your life. Yes. RuPaul is in the back behind the spotlight watching you. She has her... I'm not going to say that. That was going to be a terrible joke. I'm gonna have them play a track, and then you guys are gonna perform. And at the end, we are going to collectively vote as a whole, as a group, as a unit, on who wins. And whoever wins receives a shot, because this isn't all 18 and up, right? Okay. So, DJ, bump that track. She got a look. 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 She got a look I'm going to go stand right here at the center of the stage. I'm going to slide my hand over the top of your head. Make some noise for who you want to win. All right, I think we have our winner. It's Stevie over here. Yes, Stevie, congratulations. Can we grab our shots? I have a shot for you too, because, you know, we love alcohol. Yes. Thank you, dear. Okay, anyone, if you have a drink, put it up in the sky. Cheers, queers. Delicious. So give it up one more time for our guests this evening. Woo! Thank you, baby. All right, y'all. So thank you, Stevie. Thank you. Sorry, I'm so sweaty. Sweaty belly tonight. Okay, so we're going to take a quick intermission. Don't forget to visit our merch stand. We have a Perth special going on right now, so. Gotta remind you, a t-shirt and a poster for $40, or a t-shirt for $30 and a poster for $20. It's a lot of words. Okay. See you in 15.